So you want to know how to master Fusion, but you really don't know where to get started? Well, you've come to the right place because in this video, we are going to go over 10 simple tricks to help you begin to master DaVinci Resolve Fusion. So let's get into it. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest DaVinci Resolve tutorials put out. Starting at number 10, there is a secret menu in the Fusion tab. If you right click on the middle right here where the play section is, this actually gives you the ability to toggle on and off high quality footage and motion blur so you can have smoother looking video in Fusion when you're doing your FX. So if you've done all that and you're still running into issues, try using optimized media alongside with this. Right click on your clip, go to generate optimized media and wait for this thing to render out. So combined, all of those should give you smooth playback in Fusion. Number 9, let's be honest, we all hate those messy node trees and it really can be confusing as crap, especially if you're trying to know what's going on. Well, if you right click and go to options and go down to orthogonal pipes, this is gonna give you 90 degree bends in all of your pipes here. So now it looks a lot cooler. But then it gets even better because if you right click again and go to arrange and then select to grid, your nodes will be locked into the grid, making everything easier to keep things organized and just overall looking better. And really, like, who doesn't enjoy like a nice looking node tree? Number 8, Fusion actually doesn't allow you to hear audio while you're adding effects. This can be a problem because having pop-up effects that go along with your audio is just gonna be harder to do in general, but it can be done. And really, until this is fixed, which I actually really do think will happen, you can actually switch between the edit tab and the Fusion tab, and where you want to add like a word or a pop-up effect, you leave your playhead on in the edit tab and then just click over to Fusion tab and your playhead will be the same place. At least you'll have a starting place. It's probably one of the only solutions just for now. Number 7, you can bring multiple clips all at once into Fusion. You can do this starting in the edit tab. If you select all of your clips that you want to be in the Fusion composition, you right click on one of the clips and you go to create new Fusion comp. And this is gonna put all of them into one composition and then just jump over to Fusion and you should have all of your media ins right there. You can do this manually one at a time by actually adding in a loader node and loading up the clip or the picture that you want to add into your Fusion comp. It's slower, but you can do it. Number 6, any color grade you do will not show up in Fusion unless it's done in Fusion. So I can add this really hard color grade to this clip in the color tab and go over to Fusion and you can see it's still the normal raw footage. But if you add your color correction in Fusion, you could actually see it in the color tab. I don't suggest doing color grades in Fusion mainly because there's a whole color tab that has so many more tools than the Fusion tab has. But be aware not to add the same color grade in Fusion and the color tab at the same time because it'll just double the colors and it'll be like washed out or crazy colors and all that stuff. It's gonna look ugly. Really, if you want the most accurate representation of what your composition is gonna look like, just check in the edit tab. Number 5, if you're good at this program, but you actually just can't keep anything organized, you're going to fumble through the whole thing and it's gonna be super annoying. So tip number 5 is to use underlays. These things are super important. They're really like almost the idea of like grouping nodes, but being able to see everything at once. You can grab and drag new nodes into this group. You can also easily just take things out. It really helps to visualize different parts of your project. Number 4, curves in the spline tab. If you want to add a curve to any of your keyframes, open up the spline tab, hit this fit to zoom button so you can see everything. So now we have the line we want to add the curve to. What you're going to do is you're going to drag over this and then hit F, and then you'll be able to move your curves around and create a sharp curve or a really subtle curve. All of this is to make your animations in Fusion smoother because no one likes boring, choppy, or even just ugly animation. Number 3, merge nodes. In this program, merge nodes are literally a way of life. Like, they're everywhere. If you have any sort of composition, you need a merge node. And I mean, on the hotbar alone, there's like three different kinds of merge nodes. You have like your normal merge node, you have your particle merge node, and then you have your 3D merge node. And the thing is each of these merge nodes are just different. You can only merge up to four things with a normal merge node. With a particle merge node, you can actually only add up to three nodes together. And with a 3D merge node, as far as I can tell, you can add like up to unlimited nodes. Like I just started adding in like so many nodes here, it's crazy. And that's also really awesome because it has a lot of potential for you to do stuff. Speaking of 3D, number two is that you can literally work in like full 3D space within the program with like no plugins at all. You don't need the studio version for this. So to begin working in 3D space, all you really need is like a render 3D node. Then from there, you can start adding in other nodes like 3D text, 3D cameras. As long as it's a 3D node, you can add it in. And another small tip for 3D, just learn how to use the 3D camera. It's so awesome and it'll save you so much time with your animations in 3D space. It's pretty cool. And finally is number one, you can actually save all the things that you do, like all of your nodes, all of your effects, all of your transitions, and then just use them again. So let's say you made a whip pan transition and you just use it all the time. Well, instead of having to actually just make the whole thing over again, you can highlight all of your nodes aside from your media in and your media out, right click on any node that's highlighted, go to settings and then save all as. Name it, save it in your Fusion templates. So then in your next video, when you want the same whip pan transition, you can just go into your effects tab, grab it and drag all of your nodes out and it will just save you so much time, my friends. Did I miss something on this list? Let me know in the comments below because that's where the real conversation happens. As usual, the video on the top is a video all about the hologram effect in DaVinci Resolve and it's super sick, guys. If you haven't seen that, go check it out. And the video on the bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.